Before we get into today's episode about Kenny Clark, I just want to let you guys know that today's episode is sponsored by SeatGeek. I won't bore you guys too much, but I'm just going to let you guys know that if you use the promo code JKS and you've never used SeatGeek before, you can save $20 off on your first purchase. With the preseason already underway, tickets can be dirt cheap, especially compared to regular season prices, so you already get cheap tickets, then saving $20, it can basically be nothing almost. So if that's something you're interested in, just use the promo code JKS, that's all you have to do, $20 off your first purchase, and anyways, back to your regularly scheduled video. Okay, so I'm finally getting around to making this video. I've been meaning to make it for quite some time now. It just took me a really long time to finally get around to making it. The Packers are clearly having a lot of faith in him to try to be a very valuable part of their defense next season, and in my opinion, that's definitely a fair thing to think because he's been a very valuable part of their defense for a bit now. Like, take a look at this play. The first thing you'll notice is that there's going to be five Packers who are on the line. However, one interesting thing is what they're going to actually do here is first, they're going to have that Packer also be rushing the passer. However, it's not going to be a six-man rush, and instead, it's only going to be a four-man rush. What they're going to do is have that Packer who's in a two-point stance on the left side of the screen drop back into coverage, and the other Packer who's in a two-point stance is going to basically fake as though he is going to be rushing, but then also drop back into coverage. So it's still going to be a four-man rush, but just more of a creative way of doing it. But one interesting thing is the way that Kenny Clark is actually going to be playing in here. Because for Los Angeles' center and right guard, there's a very real chance that they both go out the block right like that, and then Kenny Clark can simply just run in between them and get a straight shot to Goff. That's kind of the way this play would hopefully work, because you know, someone does have to block the Packer who's running to the right side of the screen. And so basically, it's the center's read on this one. If the center makes a bad read, this could easily result in potentially a sack. Because if Los Angeles' center does move over to block the Packer who's actually not going to be rushing the passer, Clark can definitely run to the right side of him and get straight to Goff. That is something that can't happen, and it all depends on what the center sees and what the center does. However, as you see there, he's not fooled. He realized what's going on, and he's not going to get beat like that. So, good play. He's in good position to get to Kenny Clark. So now, what should Kenny Clark do here? Well, it's interesting, right? I mean, okay, you were hoping that you could not even have to touch somebody and go straight to Goff and get the sack. That was the hope behind this play. Although, if I'm being honest, if I'm number 50 there, Blake Martinez, I might just run over and try to sack Goff, even though it's not my assignment on that play. I mean, he's only like 2 yards away from you. I mean, sometimes it is, you know, like the whole James Harrison, when he had his 100-yard pick six, he wasn't actually supposed to drop back into coverage. Sometimes you can't abandon your assignment if there is something right in front of you. I mean, he's actually not quite as close as it looks. It's kind of an optical illusion. He's more of like 5 yards away, but he could lunge out and touch Goff, but he's going to do the right thing, honestly, and drop back into coverage. That's what you should do. I'm just saying, I might have a harder time doing that just because sometimes you want to get a sack. It's fun. But anyways, moving back to Clark. So, okay, Clark sees that there's going to be a center blocking him, but again, one-on-one matchup against a center, if you're Kenny Clark, you'll absolutely take that. But look at what Clark is going to do. This time he's actually going to do something smart. He kind of realizes that there is still going to be a gap, just now it's going to be between the center and the left guard. So he's going to move over to the left side of that center, he's going to power through, and he is going to get the Goff for a sack. This play is another interesting one, where that's how the Los Angeles Rams are going to be blocking on this play, where their center and right guard will each double team someone, and then the center will move up to block a linebacker. And you also have Clark having a 1-1 matchup against the left guard this time. From there, this is going to be a running play, so you know, Gurley is going to be running to the right side of the screen, and basically the idea is that the center and right guard both get enough of that interior lineman on the right side to move him out of the way, and that could create some bigger gaps for Gurley, and then you know, the center moves up to block the linebacker, then Gurley can run for forever. But basically, watch Clark here. What I want to take a look at is look at how far Clark is able to move that left guard over to the right side of the screen. Sometimes it's hard to tell because, you know, the entire offensive line moves over to the right side of the screen, but keep in mind, they started right there, basically 7 yards over to the left side of the screen. For Gurley, there just isn't that much separation right now, so Gurley can't really cleanly run through any hole. Gurley has to run close to Clark, and Clark is able to help make that tackle, and they don't pick up that many yards, even though they actually did a very good job of moving the other interior lineman over to the right side of the screen. You know, there's been this really interesting thing that's happened in football, where the running game is becoming more and more important, actually. I know people think that the game is going to more passing, but actually it's not really quite that way. Because of the fact that you can no longer just hit guys right over in the middle, this now means that it's more opened up, and play action becomes so much more valuable. So having a consistent running game doesn't mean as much as it meant 50 years ago, but it means a lot more than it meant 5 years ago. And the reason why I'm talking so much about that is because when you have good interior linemen like Kenny Clark, it makes running the ball that much more difficult and really has a huge impact. Interior linemen as a whole are just becoming so much more important in this game. One play that's interesting is this one, where Clark is going to be going up one-on-one against the center. So, you know, already a good idea for Clark to be going up one-on-one against the center. As a Packers fan, you're saying, all right, here we go. But one thing you'll see him do right off the bat is push that center over to the right side of the screen. He's doing this because it's play action, the thing I just spent a minute rambling on. So, you know, if it is going to be run to the right side of the screen, you want to make sure that there is no hole for a goalie to be able to run to that direction. However, it is not going to be run to the right side of the screen, and it is instead going to be a passing play. But watch what Clark does right when he realizes that this is a passing play. He has the footwork to get over to the right side of the screen and sort of disrupt this play and make Goff not be as comfortable, and even knocks Goff to the ground. Wasn't quite able to get the sack out of it. Maybe if he realized right off the bat it was passing play, he might have been able to get a sack out of it. However, he did exactly what he was supposed to do on that play. First things first, he didn't give up a run. That's the first thing he did. Second thing second, he was still able to create some pressure with Goff. And who knows, maybe if Clark wasn't there, Goff would have made a more accurate pass and it would have been a completion. That's kind of what Clark brings to the table. That's his positives. However, it also should be mentioned that even when things go wrong for Clark, he can still be effective. Like on this play, he's going to be going up one-on-one matchup once again, but this time it's going to be a right guard instead of a center. And that's actually going to throw him off. If you see right when this ball is snapped, he's definitely a little bit shocked about the fact that it's going to be a right guard blocking him instead of a center. I mean, if you look, he was definitely startled by this. He definitely was not expecting this, especially with the way 74 just sort of attacks him there. He got a little bit shocked and he wasn't expecting it. But what I like about it is look at how quickly he's going to latch his hands back on and then be able to move 74 and then be able to go over and make a tackle. I mean, that's just a good reflex, basically, of realizing what's going on, but then still being able to make a quick play. And also, guys start shoving after the play. That's always fun. But, you know, in terms of Clark, he did a very good job on that play. Even though he got a little bit shocked, he took the hit. He then still was able to very quickly get hand placement, get where he wants to be, then move his assigned man over and be able to make a stop on that run. Granted, I don't think it would have mattered too much since number 90 was not going to let anybody get by him, but as a whole, just a good play by Clark, and that kind of shows that even when things go wrong, he can find ways to still be effective and still be a solid player. I mean, that's huge, honestly. I mean, if you have guys who mix things up, and honestly, he probably should have done a better job of realizing, hey, sometimes a guard is going to block you. But even though he was shocked for whatever reason about the way that play worked, he was still able to very quickly figure it out, and I like that in a young player. And Clark is definitely very young. I mean, he's only 23 years old, despite playing in his third season. So, I mean, the fact that he's so young and still able to produce at such a high level, I think just says a lot of things for the Packers in the next upcoming seasons. He's a guy who can adjust mid-play. I do kind of wonder if Mike Daniels had something to do with that, you know, being able to play with Mike Daniels, who is one of the smarter interior linemen in the game. I wonder if he helped coach him a little bit. Maybe he did, maybe he didn't, I don't know. But either way, Clark can definitely adjust mid-play as good as any young player in the league and better than a lot of veteran players in the league. Like right here, one thing worth noting is it's actually only going to be a three-man rush. And that matters because basically for Minnesota, both of their guards are going to be in zone here. We're just going to try to make sure nobody goes in their direction. You know, both the tackles and the center who's going to be on Clark, they all try to just take them on one-on-one, and then the guards just creep over to whoever is getting beat the most. And so as you see, once this ball is snapped, well, okay, Clark moves over to the right side of the screen a little bit, so the right guard says, all right, I'm not going to leave my center on Kenny Clark. I've already seen the first part of this video, so I know that doesn't go too well. So I'll move over, I'll block him, and then we won't have to worry about Clark. Not to mention, we have a tight end chipping the other Packer on the right side of the screen, so our left tackle and left guard can double-team the other Packer, and then Kirk Cousins can have all day he wants to make a throw. However, that's where the intrigue comes in. Because that left guard is going to be moving over to block the other Packer who's on the left side of the screen, now what should Kenny Clark do here? Well, what he's going to do is move back over to the left side of the screen, and look at that. So that kind of gives him a one-on-one matchup, because the right guard then moves over to block the other Packer who's on the right side of the screen. So for now, Clark is in a perfect situation where A, he has a one-on-one matchup, B, it's against a center, and C, he has good hand placement now because he's able to get his right arm on the right side of that center's body. So from here, he can easily get around that center and get over to tackle Kirk Cousins. Just an all-around great play by Clark. And you know, I get it. I'm showing plays of him beating up on the Vikings offensive line. There's definitely better teams to talk about than the Minnesota Vikings when it comes to offensive lines. And not to mention, these are favorable matchups. You know, a lot of them him going up one-on-one against the center or something like that. But that's why I'm kind of showing them, because what are you supposed to do against favorable matchups? You're supposed to win them. And that's what Kenny Clark does, and not just in the passing game or in the running game, he does both. One play I want to talk about, and this isn't even really going to be breaking down to play too much, is he's going up one-on-one against the Miami Dolphins center. But watch this just ferocious swim move he's going to do. Watch how quickly he moves his right arm over that center and then gets over to make a tackle. Again, that's not really much of a breakdown as it is, hey, look at this cool play. That was pretty awesome, wasn't it? But I mean, yeah, I mean, that just goes to show what kind of talent we're dealing with here when it comes to Kenny Clark. I mean, when you can make jaw-dropping plays from the nose, I mean, that's just what you love to see if you're a defensive coordinator or just a fan of football in general. I mean, he even kind of bumped into that left guard a little bit, but was still able to have the footwork to get over to the left side of the screen and still make that tackle. His footwork is very key. I do like his footwork a lot. Having an interior lineman who can move definitely can be very beneficial in several different ways. I know Pro Football Focus, they love Kenny Clark. I mean, last year they gave him a 90.5 grade last year, so they're definitely big fans of Kenny Clark. And also, in terms of tackling attempts, they gave him credit for making 35 out of 38 total tackle attempts, so he's definitely a very talented player. And of course, the one stat we'll all talk about is just the 10.5 sacks in the past two seasons. But another stat that people don't really talk about too much is this guy took 720 snaps from the inside last year. I mean, that's a workhorse type mentality. And oh yeah, I should mention he took 720 snaps in just 13 games. If he played those last three games, he could have had closer to 850 snaps or so. So I mean, again, less than Aaron Donald, but more than pretty much every other interior lineman in the league. I'm sure there's a few others you could point to as well, but as a whole, he's definitely a workhorse for Green Bay, and for good reason, this guy can play. And going back to what I was just talking about before I got on that tangent, footwork is very important, and this play will be an example of that. They're going to have Matthews, who's on the edge right there, run through the inside of the tackle, and then they're going to pull Kenny Clark over to the top half of the screen, try to get around the tackle, and get a straight shot to the quarterback. That's the way this play will hopefully work. Although also worth mentioning, there is going to be a halfback in the game, so for this play to really work out the way you want it to, the halfback would need to be running a route for this play to really work. If the back is going to be blocking here, then well, Kenny Clark would still have to get around a halfback. Still a very favorable matchup, but just not quite as perfect. The most favorable matchup is when you're going against no one, obviously. And so as you see, this play starts to work out perfectly. I mean, Matthews does a good job of pulling that left tackle over to the inside of the screen, and now Clark can try to get around him, and especially since the halfback is in fact running a route, Clark will have nobody in front of him if he does get around that tackle. He's not Usain Bolt, but he can definitely move, especially for his size. One last play, once again, it's going to be a 1-1 matchup, this time against the right guard, and it is going to be a running play this time. And one thing you'll see is that 77 right there is actually in pretty good position to be blocking Clark. They're going to try to run the ball to their left of Clark, so you know, they're going to have to try to make as big of a gap as possible, and that probably is the most important block of this play. But watch how Clark, despite the leverage, is able to stick his right arm out there and still be able to make this tackle. It still went for 4 yards, but it didn't really go for too much, largely because he just had the awareness to be able to get his arm out there and make that tackle. So yeah, that's Kenny Clark. He's a really good player, really talented player, and he's a huge part of that Packers defense. So yeah, that's my video on Kenny Clark. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and as always, thanks for watching.